freedom. You've lost a couple of math bets to me, haven't you, my friend?
Afraid so.
But I've got a brilliant one for you that I know you can work out.
Okay.
It's very easy. It's so easy this time that I may well have to buy you a drink.
That sounds good so far.
Right. I'm going to Roman numerals.
Okay.
Again, and he's good at those, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's been studying.
Yes.
So we've got 1 plus xi equals x, which is, as I'm sure you're aware, 1 plus 11 equals 10.
Hmm.
Now, do you remember last time, on our very first little math bet, that I let you add a straight line?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Which he failed at miserably. Then the second time, you failed to recognize that you could add a curved line.
Mm-hmm.
This time, you don't get to add any lines. That puzzle has to work exactly as it is without adding any lines. And that's for a drink. Duh. My friends at home may have already noticed, people always pay the price for the solution. So there you go.
Can I just...
No, you can't do the little covery model thing. Although that was kind of nice. Calvin Klein would love you. You know, like,
try.
I'm voguing. The puzzle is a working. No, that puzzle has to work exactly as it is.
Mm-hmm. We turn it upside down, or x equals?
9
plus 1. I
he
did it!
Finally won
I got it!
Best. High five!
Yes, now I would love a drink, please.
Gina, cut this man off. No, that's the puzzle, yeah. So you turn it upside down.
Good for you.
And here's a good thing for you though, Peter. I'll tell you one of the great secrets of bar bets. It's not about winning every bar bet. It's just about winning more than you lose. And right now, you're 9,000 drinks down.
Hey, it's better
but
than
congrats
zero.
On winning one.
Better
congrats
than zero.
On winning one. Try it out on your friends, and they won't be as smart as him, because very few people are.
Very true.
And that's how you do tricks with math. I'm glad you won one. I mean, just one. I mean, I felt so bad.